everyone. Welcome to Inside the Dojo. I'm your host, Willie the Bam Johnson, along with my lovely family, my wife, Kimberly Johnson, my son, Marco the Answer Johnson, and my two precious jewels, Messiah Johnson and Zarian Johnson, a part of our Dojo Kids crew. We're here to empower you, get you going, motivating you with the principles, concepts of martial arts as a lifestyle. Inside the Dojo.
He's super bad. He's out of sight. He's black dynamite.
Have sex when you please.
Yeah.
Dynamite, baby. Nipsey still ain't paid up.
Solid. I'm on it, B.
This time he's out of sight. He's killing who we want to. So you know he's dynamite.
He's dynamite.
Who's that? I'm looking for Nipsey.
There's no Nipsey here.
Now I'm gonna ask you one more time. Where's Nipsey?
Here I am, sucker!
Excuse me, sir, are you famous?
Well, not really. That looks like some famous folks.
I thought I saw you somewhere, sir, in a movie or something. What's your name?
Cuba Gooding Jr.
What's up, Mike? Can we get an introduction? Can you tell us something about yourself?
Well, you know, I'm a Scorpio. I like long walks in the park. And I really like the music of the Carpenters.
All right. Come on, man, for real. Come on, Mike.
Michael Jai White. You know, actor. I play make-believe for a living.
Okay.
Yeah.
We got a lot of kids on the underground market in this DVD industry that really look up to you. I mean, you are a hero on the underground market. I know that because I'm there. And, I mean, they see you undisputed. They like, man, Mike, the only one that's keeping it real. What would you say to those fans out there on the underground level that's following you and counting on you to keep it real for them?
Well, you know, hey, on the underground level, only between me and you, you know, I don't know if you know about the legend of the Trojan horse. You know, well, the Greeks made a. Made up a horse and they hid inside, you know, and they surprised it as a gift. They packaged it as a gift, and then when the enemy opened up the gates to accept the gift, once the soldiers who were inside the horse were inside the gates, they came out and all hell broke loose. I want you to remember that analogy of the Trojan horse. Because I'll package certain things up in a certain way, but then when I get inside, I'm gonna show and prove. You know, I'm gonna represent. There's a reason why I ain't sold out, and I'm not gonna sell out. So I got my own way about getting inside, and then, you know, doing my damage from the inside. You know what I mean? So Trojan horse.
Give me your MySpace page.
Say again.
MySpace page. How can they get in contact with you and become a fan?
You know what? I'm so not technical. I'm so on the creative thing.
Right.
I think I can be found on MySpace under my name. I don't know what the.
All right. Tell them about your movies. What you got coming out that they need to be in store for, please.
All right. I got two flicks coming out this year. Well, actually three. I'm in Batman: Dark Knight and Blood and Bone. This one right here. Blood and Bone, total martial arts thing. It's me stepping out into my martial arts thing on a real level. Before you seen me do little stuff, but now I'm stepping out on mine. You know what I mean? This is my flick. So it's representing what I've been doing. And another one called Black Dynamite.
I will strive to develop myself in a positive manner, avoiding anything that reduces my physical, my mental, and my spiritual growth. I will strive to develop self-discipline in order to bring out the best in myself and in others. I will use what I learned in Wushudo in a humble state of consciousness, respecting the laws of mankind, living by the laws of the universal creator.
All right, everybody. Willie the Bam Johnson here with Fuya Magazine, from the underground to the mainstream. We got one of my heroes, my main man, Mr. Michael Jai White. We always talk to y'all about him. I mean, he done had a great success with Black Dynamite out there right now. I know everybody done heard about it, done seen it written up in all the magazines, so forth, giving it great ratings, bringing it right back to how the martial arts used to be back in the 70s. Mr. Mike, tell him, I mean, what was it like working on Black Dynamite?
Well, I mean, it was a labor of love because, I mean, I wrote the movie, got produced and, you know, started it clearly. And so, I mean, it was a lot of fun, man, because, you know, I hired my friends, and you know, that genre meant so much to me. I know it has been with you as well. And, you know, it was a genre that, you know, we take great pride in, because it finally showed African Americans in a fashion that was, you know, that was worthy. You know, worthy fashion. It was not, we weren't servants and maids and all that type of stuff. We were the heroes, and, you know, we had strong alpha males as role models. And so, you know, I wanted to pay homage to that, you know, that alpha male that I grew up,
you know, it's interesting because as you talk, and I'm smiling, because I remember the Muscle and Fitness Man, I guess it was about your workout, and then it was leading into the movie. But they had a shot of you when you was a little kid, back in the day when you was practicing martial arts, you know, wrong with your cones and all that.
Right.
So now, coming up in the 70s, and coming from a kung fu movie, and walking through New York, and feeling the vibe of the street, and I know you made the nunchakus and all that stuff. What was that culture like? I mean, even being a part of a dojo, I mean, because people look, it's like, some reason they look like, they think that that life never existed. But there was no dojos in the inner city. There was no good instructors in the inner city. What was that culture like for you?
Well, see, one thing is, I explained to a lot of people that the martial arts came by way of the inner city.
Okay.
I mean, it came, you know, from the Orient.
Yes, sir.
And it was, you know,
hi, my name is Master Kimber Johnson. Today I'm here to talk to you about the art and etiquette of belt tying. A lot of times moms are running in from work or another activity like soccer or so forth, and they're always trying to rush to put the belt onto the child. So basically what I do, I always explain to them that there are different styles and systems of how they tie their belt in different art forms. So basically what I do is I call this the baby method, and it's a way to teach the moms how to put the belt on in a secure manner so it doesn't fall off in the class. It is precise and it is very neat and focus driven, so just the way I want my students to be. So first thing we do is we put the belt and we pull it to the half point. We basically fold it in half. Take the center part, put it on your belly button. Then we're going to take it around the body. And keep in mind, this is the easiest way for anybody to tie the belt. Then the other part is gonna go right on top, all the way around the belt, the stomach area. And then the top portion will literally fold through, loop through, like a shoelace. And then you're gonna have two flaps. And then basically what I tell the parents or anyone that I'm teaching to tie their belt is the top flap will go on top. And then you're gonna kind of have like the unique breast cancer symbol, and you're gonna reach through the hole, grab it, pull it through, and then you should end up with a fortune cookie. Now my belt is a little tore up. I've had it since I was 8 years old, so you can't technically see the fortune cookie, but it is there. So another thing is, I see a lot of kids throw their belts on the floor. That's a no-no, or hang them around their neck. You never want to do that. Those are signs of disrespect to what you have learned or what you are going to be learning. And although the belt is not the end all to everything in the martial arts, you should hold it near and dear to your heart.
It's your boy Margo the Answer Johnson coming at you live and direct inside the dojo with my dojo kids. Alright, what y'all about to witness is my workout, the beast workout with these kids. This is their first tryout, my team that I have putting together. We're taking over 2016. We're starting in 2015, but we're going all the way to 2016. We'll be right back. belt. We got numerous kids, man. Sit back and watch and see what we do, man. It is the Dojo Kids. It's Marco the Answer Johnson's Inside the Dojo. We coming at you live and direct. Sit back, don't move, set your dials. Let's go.